Hello.
Hello, Ricardo. So here we have the room ready for you so you can
Great.
start talking now. So this is Ricardo. You're up there on the screen. Thank you.
Okay, I can start.
Yes.
Okay, great. So good morning. Of course, thank you for inviting me. As you know, my name is Ricardo. Can you see me? Oh, good evening. My name is Ricardo Preda, and I did a PhD in computer science and string theory. Reason I decided to change career. And I started looking around, the jobs that traditionally are associated with a degree in physics, but it just didn't fit me. So, with a friend of mine, we decided to found our own company. We developed a way to represent inventions and technologies as abstract entities that could be manipulated quantitatively. And that, in this aspect, is where my experience and skills in my background in physics was essential, really useful and essential. And we are using this model that we developed to invent new products for clients. It's a model that can be applied to any fields. It ranges from complex products such as CT medical scanner to simple one like clothes that reduce pollution and so on. And also we are using the model to process technical text by software. You think of this as big data, and instead of applying it to, politics or prediction shopping, to innovation and technology landscape, so on which we do strategic analysis and forecast. So this is just to tell you where I am now, what I'm doing now. But to connect to the physics, I have to say the changing was hard, not in practice, but the real obstacle was my perception of things. You know that physics is a passion more than a job. And I identified myself as a theoretical physicist and could not picture myself doing anything else. So the main obstacle was to decide that I wanted to live here rather than to do something else. Then actually, when I started actually doing other stuff, everything came really easy. And I realized two things. The first is that everyone that is a physicist will always be a physicist in the way he approaches things. So we just play with different objects. And more importantly, there is really a kaleidoscope of interesting challenges out there that we physicists can give our contributions, and also very fun to do. And I think that our experience as researchers, as physicists, theoretical physicists also, will be an invaluable asset in our jobs too. Well, there are some obvious reasons. Of course, we have a very strong mathematical backgrounds. Maybe we have programming skills. We know how to browse literature to find solutions. There are also less obvious advantages. A minor one is reputation. String theory is started to be known outside the physics world and is considered, very tough, very. So whether it's true or not, it is the most difficult branches of physics, but people perceive this outside physics more or less that way, so it's a bit hard. But what turned out to be the really most important advantage is that the different mindset and approach to problems that physicists have. We have flexibility, clearness of thought, the ability to spot patterns and causal links. And I found out, well, that's my experience at least, that is not common. Even very clever people, but they have a different approach to things. So what we can offer is a different point of view from that of engineers, economists, doctors, and a combination of their point of view and our point of view can lead to real breakthrough in other fields than physics. So to conclude with a few things that I've learned from my experience, I don't know how general this could be, of course, it's my experience, but I hope that some of this can be useful to some of you. Well, on a very practical level, learning a programming language is very useful out there, but on a more, general philosophical career level, what I'd like to say is that if you decide to change, do not be afraid to do it. Jump and everything will go well. Network a lot, find the right people don't do it alone, basically. Find the right people to do it together. And do not think, at the traditional choices. Explore the new technologies, the startup world. It's very hard to start your own company, but this is the right historical moment. They're the best condition. Of course, it's not easy, but and you will. Well, I realized that the great satisfaction action can arrive from where you less expect them. That's it. So if you have questions.
I'll just repeat so that Ricardo can your microphone.
Does it mean exactly don't do it alone?
So Ricardo, can you
yes.
hear me?
Yeah.
So one of the participants is asking, what does it mean, what do you mean when you say don't do it alone?
Okay. Well, we as researchers, we are used to work in a team, of course, with our supervisor if you're doing the PhD. But basically, the ideas come from you. Your idea in your paper comes from you, and it's always you studying in your. If you change career, of course, if you stay in physics, maybe it will work just fine. You will see that it's different. The challenges require usually different expertise. In every company or in the public sector, where you find a job outside the academy. Path, you need different skills, and you cannot have all of them. And also, even the time is limited. You can only do 24 hours a day, and of course, you don't want to work all of them. And so, finding the right people is definitely surrounding yourself with the correct team is the way to achieve things, but also to work easier without you have to have a working environment. That's for when you actually do things, but also to find a new job which really you like. I think networking is essential. Well, of course, it's essential everywhere in life, even in physics. You go to conferences. But again, since my bit of experience is that you want to find a path which is not the standard, something that you like, that is similar to what you were doing in research. You don't want to go in an office and do an 8-hour job. Well, maybe you won't, but let's assume you do not want to. Then, of course, if you open yourself to many, many other different point of views and people, and then you will find that thing somewhere, maybe in the US, maybe in your country, but in an environment you didn't imagine. So you have to explore a lot. When I mean explore, I don't mean physically, but people-wise, that's what I meant.
Okay. Well, let's thank Ricardo again for his advice. Thanks a lot
for your time. So, good luck, everyone.
Thank you. Bye.